then when I got to Bolivia, I was like, shady suspect.
The group will be fined because you both have broken the rules.
That's crap. That's crap.
Briggs and I were offered an exemption. I'm going to tell you we took it.
You're missing the large picture, man. See, you're taking the small picture, which is you, and you're putting that in front of the big picture, which is the group.
Can you all please rotate your journals four people to the left? These are your new journals.
I heard a very interesting rumor.
What's that?
That you were totally calling someone a bitch in your diary?
That's like really strong vocabulary.
Yeah.
You have 7 minutes left to go.
Try an A at the end.
How'd you know that was an A?
Because I'm the mole.
I wasn't trying to run the show.
You did.
No, I wasn't.
Got it. Yes.
That's what I'm talking about. Right there, man. Way to go, bro.
I think everybody is voting for Olivia.
Let the games begin.
Yeah! I got one!
I tallied all the results. Olivia was selected as the least favorite player. You can take $50,000 if you walk out of the game tonight.
Oh, my God.
Thank you for not liking me.
Olivia and the mole just left.
I guess the group will be missing their prime suspect.
Spend the rest of your life with me and marry me.
I don't know if I can do this.
She's gonna do it.
Oh my God, oh my God, oh my God! Oh my God!
What is that? What is that? That's what I'm talking about!
I've been drinking with you today.
It's now Darwin's turn to hit the ball, but he actually encourages Dorothy to hit the ball.
Darwin.
It's a game.
It's just a game.
I don't understand hesitation. Nobody hesitated but you. What are you doing?
I do not like bugs. They're so gross.
Hey, get over here.
What? Bob, Allie, Lisa, Patrick, Rob, Myra, Katie, Darwin, Bribs, Al.
Final episode of The Mole, The Next Betrayal. Tonight, for the first time, we'll reveal who is the winner and who is the mole. It's been many months since Bill, Heather, and Dorothy took that final quiz on the mountaintop in Calascio, Italy. The quiz results have been tabulated, and now the three finalists are waiting behind those three locked doors. Tonight, the life of one of them will change dramatically, because one of them has won $636,000. In the next hour, we'll reveal the winner and the mole. We'll show you how the mole successfully sabotaged many of the games and reveal all the hidden clues to the mole's identity. Finally, we'll reunite all 14 players for the first time since the beginning of the show. So, have you figured it out? Who is the mole?
Is it Dorothy, the 24-year-old musician from New York City? Heather, the 25-year-old PR rep from Dallas, Texas? Or Bill, the 58-year-old retired admiral from Oak Harbor, Washington? Each of these final players have had their share of suspicious moments this season. Let's take a look. If you choose to wear that outfit, you can double whatever money the group has earned. It's basically a diaper with bibs, pacifier, and a cute little hat.
Not a chance in hell.
You broke the gnome. Don't earn the $30,000 for the pot.
He might have dropped it on purpose. I mean, I considered doing the same thing, so.
This went on my back the entire mile. It took me an hour and 40 minutes.
See, you'll be fine.
Fills
out.
I don't see how he couldn't last more than 8 minutes.
If your action matches their prediction, you earn $10,000, and more importantly, you get to spend the rest of today with your loved ones.
Yeah, I think Dorothy will jump.
I am not going to jump.
Dorothy was the only one who didn't get to see her mom. Looks like you took a personal hit. But at the same time, you took a hit from the pot.
The last piece of cake was the cake without the blueberry, and Dorothy jumped to volunteer for it.
Dude, I haven't eaten anything this entire trip. I'm trying to pack in as much as I can.
If you were me, would you think it was suspicious?
Directly behind the Arco del Scaletti. How many stairs lead up to the top of the hill?
Okay, bye. I definitely suspect Dorothy to be the mole. I mean, she could still be in Vicenza right now counting the steps. We don't know.
You will have 2 minutes to look at the square and to try to select Ron from the second story window. If you do not successfully pick out Katie's dad, you don't earn the money, and Katie does not get to see her father.
I need my glasses for this. I'm gonna say the guy in the blue shirt, but I don't know. No.
Sorry.
Maybe I suckered myself into a coalition with a mole.
Come on, Heather.
Heather had told a couple of us she used to be a gymnast, and she fell off without being touched.
$100,000 is in the pot, but that $100,000 is at risk.
There's a giant python in that room, and it was pitch black.
I'm not gonna do it?
No way.
No way in the world is a girl that's shown as much guts as Heather gonna run from a snake. That's just sort of the final blow for me.
So it's time to say hello to our 11 executed players back together for the first time since the beginning of the game. Welcome back, everyone. It's nice to see you. As you know, Bill, Dorothy, and Heather are the only three remaining in the game. And right now, they are waiting behind those three locked doors for the winner to be revealed. But first, I have two questions for all of you. Now that you've seen all the shows, who is the winner and who's the mole? Bob.
I think Dorothy is the winner and Bill is the mole.
Allie?
I think Dorothy is the winner and I think Heather is the mole.
Lisa?
I think Dorothy is the mole and Heather is the winner.
Patrick, who do you think is the winner and who do you think is the mole?
I think Dorothy is the mole and I think Bill is the winner.
Rob?
I think Dorothy is the winner and Bill is the mole.
Myra?
I think Heather is the winner and Dorothy is the mole.
Alavi?
Dorothy is the winner and Heather is the mole.
Very interesting. You guys are all over the place, all right?
I think that Dorothy is the winner and Heather is the mole.
Well, Dorothy is the mole, and I think Heather wins.
You say that very confidently.
Yeah, I don't know why. I'm here with these guys.
Ribs.
I think Heather's the winner, and I still think Alavi is the mole.
Hey, I'm still not buying it. She's not.
I think Bill's the mole.
You know?
Still a guess, but I think that Bill is the winner, and I think Heather is the mole.
Very interesting. All right. Of the remaining three players, each could rightly be accused of sabotage, but only one of them, of course, is the mole. Now, Dorothy, Heather, and Bill sit behind those three locked doors. When we come back, we'll find out their fate, who's the winner, and who is the mole. Stay tuned. Welcome back to the final episode of The Mole, The Next Betrayal. We've reunited the 11 executed players. Now it is time to find out who's the winner and who is the mole. The results have all been tabulated. The player who scored highest on the final quiz is the winner. Now, we asked you guys before who you thought was the winner and who you thought was the mole. Four of you said Heather is the mole, four of you said Dorothy, and three of you said Bill. We'll soon see. Dorothy, Bill, and Heather each sit behind one of these locked doors. Now, I have three keys in my hand, one for each of them. Only the winner's key will open their door. Are you ready? Let's meet the winner. I'm going to place each of these keys into the slot in the door. Players, when I ask you to, you will try to put the key into the lock. The one who emerges is the winner. Heather, Bill, Dorothy, one of you is about to win $636,000. Players, stand up, approach the door, and try to open it. Congratulations. You win $636,000. Are you surprised?
Yes, I'm floored. Oh, my God. I mean, to even make it to the final round and to actually win, it's a complete shock. I never thought it would happen.
Yeah. It was touch and go there sometimes. Well, now that we know who the winner is, it's time to find out who is the mole. This key opens the door to the mole. You know who the mole is? Place it in their door. It is finally time to find out who is the mole. Mole, open your door. You fooled the majority of the players, the majority of the game. Really.
Thank you.
Excellent, excellent job.
Bill, why didn't you let Heather out?
Hey, come on out, Heather.
I was 99% sure that she won.
Well, see, you do that
all the time. Yeah.
amazing game. When we come back, we'll learn that it was actually Heather who caught onto the mole and gave him to Dorothy, a move that ultimately cost Heather the game. We'll be right back. Welcome back to the final episode of The Mole, The Next Betrayal. As we've just learned, Heather is the game's last victim. Dorothy is the winner of $636,000. And Bill is the mole. Who's surprised? Patrick, are you surprised?
I ended this game the same way I began it, clueless. So I'm not surprised.
How about you, Katie?
I'm very surprised. I mean, even though Heather and I had a coalition at the very end, I think she pulled the wool over my eyes. I really thought that she was the mole.
Bribs, how about you? You were the first one, I think, to ever vote for Bill, but only once. I think you did it on the third quiz. What changed your mind?
In a word, Darwin.
You trusted a lawyer.
I trusted a lawyer. I think I had him pegged in the second quiz. I put everything into the second quiz, and eight of the questions were gunned for Bill. But Darwin convinced me that he threw absolutely no questions towards Bill on the first quiz. Therefore, you know, Darwin should have been the one that was executed.
It was either zero or one question.
Oh, well, you just happened to miss that one?
So, Darwin, Brainiac, you ruled out Bill from the get-go.
Yep. Shows how good a player I am.
Not only that, you convinced a couple people not to to go for Bill.
I felt like you had to eliminate at least three people on the first quiz in order not to spread yourself too thin. And I just didn't think it was Bill, so I didn't give him any answers, or I gave him, like, one, and it took me forever to take the quiz, so I pretty much eliminated him because I figured if there was a tie, I would be out right away. So I have no idea what happened, but you're sneaky, man.
Al, I know that on the night you were executed, you voted for Bill on the quiz, but you split your vote. Who else did you suspect?
Dorothy. I split it between Bill and Dorothy because I was still confused at that point. There was a lot of things that pointed to the both of them, to me. But I guess with Bill, we talked about a lot of things, and we got, like, really close, you know, and he pulled the wool right off my eyes because, I guess, in my head, I knew he was a prime suspect, but in my heart, because we had such a good relationship, I was like, I was forgiving him. He's making, you know, it's just Bill making mistakes, you know.
And Dorothy, you won the game, but it was actually Heather who discovered Bill first and turned you onto Bill. Heather formed a coalition with Dorothy. If she hadn't done that, she might have won the game. Let's take a look how Heather discovered Bill.
Heather's initial strategy was to form a coalition.
Katie and I have definitely bonded. We are absolutely working together and sharing information.
Heather and Katie immediately started listing their suspects. Their suspicions included Dorothy and Bill, but topping their list was Olavia.
I believe that Olavia is my primary suspect.
After successfully making it through five executions, Heather and Katie were convinced they were on the right track. Until Olavia took a $50,000 bribe and left the game.
It's like starting over. I'm absolutely floored.
With Olavia gone, Katie and Heather were forced to focus their suspicions on a new player, Dorothy.
Dorothy could definitely be the mole, and she's on my list of suspects.
Sticking to their strategy, they both took the quiz thinking Dorothy was the mole and tied for the lowest score. Since Katie was 11 seconds slower than Heather, she was executed.
I'm sorry that Katie's gone, but in this instance, it told me that Dorothy is not the mole. So now I'm on to my third suspect. I think Bill is the mole.
Heather's confidence was shaken, so she turned to the one person she was now convinced was not the mole, Dorothy.
Wouldn't hurt you to work with me and get rid of the guys, right?
How do I know you're not going to misdirect me or misdirect them to knock me out?
Yeah.
She was enough of a question mark in my mind that I needed to have her convince me she wasn't the mole.
If I had my Bible right here, I swear I would put my hand on it and swear. I swear on my ring.
What Heather didn't realize is that up until that moment, Dorothy had suspected her of being the mole.
Heather has been one of my main suspects in the last few rounds.
Heather's plan was to share information with Dorothy and deflect suspicion from Bill.
Like, I truly think that we can be the last two people here. And you know what? If I get second place, that's fine with me.
All right, who do you want to knock out first?
Ribs. We are definitely close, and we're definitely sharing information, but I think I'm really using him just to my benefit. I'm just sort of toying with Bribs a little.
Earlier today, I said something to Bribs about would he believe me if I told him I was the mole and that I'm telling him this because I wanted him to stick around. And he came back with, no, I wouldn't. Did it on purpose. I did it to confuse him because I know that he suspected me.
Heather did manage to confuse Bribs and got him to split his vote between her and Dorothy on the night he was executed.
My strategy worked.
Oh my God, I can't believe I'm still here. Heather, I owe you a really big one for steering me away from Bribs.
Yes, you do.
I feel really lucky to have switched at the last minute. I mean, I was waffling up until the last second.
Although Al was beginning to suspect Bill, Heather and Dorothy managed to shake his confidence enough to make him falter on the next quiz.
The only thing that we can do together is to rattle Al, and I don't think that's going to be hard to do.
Heather and Dorothy successfully conned Al into splitting his vote. Heather got exactly what she wanted, two women in the final round. But teaming up with Dorothy was about to cost her the game. She was now facing an opponent who was well prepared. And while Heather was becoming physically and emotionally exhausted, Dorothy was now focused and could see a clear path to victory, all thanks to Heather.
I'm scared to death that Dorothy will beat me. And then I'll just be like, why? I'll think, why in the world did I form a coalition with her? Because everything that's happened so far, I could have done on my own.
I really don't want to do this.
Emotional exhaustion and lack of confidence led to Heather's eventual decline, landing her in the position of runner-up. Although she stumbled at the end, Heather distinguished herself by playing the game with integrity, intelligence, and heart.
If you want the exemption, leave these two here in their cells overnight.
I'm not going to take it. There's no way. We did this together, so. I'm just tired of this game. It's so hard.
It's a game. It's just a game.
Really just drained me completely, tested everything. And the fact that I did as well as I did is just incredible. And so I'm proud of myself, really, and just excited. It's just something that I'll always remember.
Did you realize that you gave Dorothy the mole?
I just completely lost confidence and focus. I was so emotionally exhausted. I mean, I felt like there was no way to win the game without a coalition just because that's sort of what I had in my head going into it. I thought that Bribs and Al and Dorothy for sure thought it was Bill, and I thought it was just going to be a question of information. Right. I was wrong.
Well, in the end, Bill, of course, was the mole. And in the final quiz, Dorothy beat her coalition partner by one question.
I knew it. Wow. I knew it.
Well, coming up, we'll take a look at how Dorothy won and how Bill sabotaged the games. We'll be right back. Welcome back. For those of you who just tuned in, unfortunately for Heather, she was the game's last victim. Bill was the mole, and Dorothy won $636,000. Let's find out now how she did it.
If there's one thing you can say about Dorothy, it's that she's smart.
She's so smart.
She's very smart.
One smart cookie.
She's going to be tough to get out of there.
And she played to win. Each box below contains a combination.
Unscramble the letters in the pie segment.
There's only one word that can be made from all of these letters. In the dumb versus smart game, she showed off her keen intellect, earning an exemption and $50,000 for the pie.
Trustfulness.
Please give me your answer.
Trustfulness.
That is correct.
Is it really?
Wow.
Cold.
Again and again, she pulled the answers seemingly out of thin air.
$90 is correct.
You had the correct answers.
Way to go.
Good job.
You are amazing.
Wow.
But Dorothy's last-minute wins appeared very suspicious to her teammates.
With 3 seconds left, she comes out with mistrustfulness.
Amazing how you pull that off.
Yeah.
Dorothy seemed to get too, just out of nowhere. both on the second answer, and that was very suspicious.
Her second show of smarts came in the assembly line game.
Dwindling numbers, guys, what does that mean? Four more losers, we have four numbers.
While everyone else was focused on the car, Dorothy miraculously came up with a combination for the lock on the door.
So I'd already tried 6543, and I knew it had to be something to do with how many players were currently in the game and how many would be left at the end. And that's really what prompted me to reverse the numbers. I got it, guys.
You got it?
What was it?
2456.
To the remaining players, Dorothy's intelligence became a source of suspicion. But what she had in brains...
I can't reach!
She certainly didn't have in brawn.
Dorothy has managed to somehow or another mess up almost every game she's been in.
She just can't exert any physical energy without feeling sick.
Guys, I can't even hold this up!
She can't see anything. She's like Mr. Magoo without her glasses. She's barely on the logs. She's like making out shapes, you know, trying to swing at the mountains.
Oh, it just happened. I'm trying to play these games to win, and I bumble.
Her lack of coordination proved useful in conjuring up more suspicion.
Dorothy could most definitely be the mole.
Are you telling me that you can't run?
She volunteered to be a runner.
You can't ride a bike.
Could be that she never rode a bike. I don't know. It just looked a little suspicious.
Another quality that threw off her fellow players, her mole-like persona.
Dorothy's just shady. She doesn't give a whole lot of herself.
Little did Darwin know that it was he who gave Dorothy the idea to have a mole-like demeanor.
He said, "You'd make a great mole because nothing extra comes out of your mouth."
From that point on, she kept her emotions under wraps. When she lost in the relative bungee game and was the only player not reunited with her loved one, Dorothy kept her pain well concealed from the other players, adding to their mounting suspicion.
My game persona is a very contained person. I'm trying not to, you know, explode too much, but it's hard to keep everything stuffed in there.
Her mysterious persona was working. Like tin soldiers, Allie, Patrick, Katie, and Bribs all turned their suspicion towards Dorothy and picked her as the mole on the night of their executions. But this would mean nothing for Dorothy without a little old-fashioned luck.
You can take $50,000 if you walk out of the game tonight.
We'll never know if Olavia would have won the game had she not taken the bribe.
Thank you for not liking me.
But we do know that Dorothy wouldn't have, because that night she scored the lowest on the quiz and would have been executed.
Wow.
Damn.
Dorothy was single-handedly responsible for adding $70,000 to the pot. She gained 3 exemptions for her teammates and 2 for herself. Her intelligence and ability to stay calm and focused gave her the winning edge.
Dorothy, you had obviously a very clever strategy, create sort of an air of mystery about yourself. I got to ask you, are you that clumsy? Are you like the klutziest person in the world?
You can see me. I walk across the street and I just trip with, you know, unprovoked, and I just...
You can't ride a bike?
I had a Desert Rose Huffy bike when I was in 6th grade, and that was the last bike I owned. And that mountain bike was set for someone who's like 6 feet tall, like him. Okay. So obviously someone of my stature would have a difficult time handling that bike.
Did your strategy change over time?
My strategy coming into the game was to sabotage the games I participated in, and as it worked out, I didn't have to do much intentional sabotage because I naturally bumbled all those games. But after Darwin and my little conversation, I tried to focus on, you know, acting suspicious in social situations. Give them enough information so that they think I'm the mole, but make it seem like I'm uncomfortable and, you know, keep them talking about themselves.
Right. Is there anything you'd like to say to Heather? You
coalition I feel
partner?
Really bad. No, hey, you don't. You deserve it. My God.
Do you think luck played a significant role for you?
Yeah, I think luck played a huge role, especially with the whole blueberry thing. I mean, it did look very suspicious, you know, jumping up. I kept telling everyone I'm not suspicious. No one believed me.
That's what
suspicious, I think.
Well, congratulations. You really, amazing game. Well, while Heather and Dorothy's coalition proved fruitful, there were many others that did not. In fact, there's one player I like to call the king of coalitions. Darwin, let's take a look. We put together a little montage.
Coalitions are interesting. I've got to figure out how they work.
What do you think? You're up for something like that?
Sure.
It's
far as a coalition goes. I think it only takes, you know, a wink and a couple words and you've got one formed.
Early on, Darwin decided that Bill wasn't the mole and convinced his coalition partners of the same.
Bob, tell me what you think about this idea of getting together a group of like four or five people. We all take the test, basically having the same answers at our fingertips. So we'll all pretty much assure ourselves that we won't be the one with the worst score.
Darwin and I are pretty good right now, pretty solid. I'm just being very cautious because I don't know if he'd set up a little coalition with Bill beforehand. He has told me that Bill's a little too dry, and slow, a little boring.
I never said you were slow.
I'm telling you, and then I'll tell like three other people. So that way we can still play our coalition.
After reading Bill's journal, I'm convinced that he's not the mole.
Just don't know who to trust, so I'm trying to cover my bases.
Darwin seemed to learn nothing from the fact that each of his coalition partners, except for Bill, had been executed.
I don't know, I was about to say, let's go over the questions.
Flip them out. Katie's no longer shady. Al, I've eliminated. Have you eliminated Al?
Yeah, I've gotten rid of Al.
I've eliminated Bill.
You don't have to convince me that Alavia is my top suspect.
No, I'm just saying, I'm just laying out my thoughts here.
I think everybody is voting for Alavia.
I think Bill's really starting to try and make people think that he's the mole. And I've already eliminated him, so I'm not gonna worry about him.
Darwin and I ruled Bill out through our educational guesses.
I read people fairly well, and I think I'm reading Alavia. I could be wrong. Somebody home right now is going, you ain't reading nothing well. You're way off. It's Bill. Maybe it is. I don't know.
Jesus Christmas. That is the best. That's the best line.
Oh my God!
So, King of Coalitions over there, Darwin. Everybody. Why were you so eager to form coalitions?
Because I wanted information. I felt like if I had more than one coalition going, and somebody, let's say Lisa gave me information, and Bribs gave me the same information, two different pairs of eyes, could confirm that information for me. So, obviously, I was way off.
You lasted a long time.
Yeah, you did.
That was pure luck. What are you talking about?
I've got to see now. He said I was slow.
No, I didn't say that.
I was dumb.
I did not say that.
And earlier on, not honorable, faking honorable. We need to talk later.
Come on, man. Yeah.
But it's Al who's a good judge of people over there.
Yeah.
Well, as you know, being the mole required a constant mask of lies and deception. Winning the game required compulsive attention to detail. How carefully were you at home watching? Did you guess correctly? When we come back, find out which games the mole sabotaged and see the hidden clues from the entire season. We'll be right back. Bill McDaniel, the person who figured out and won the game, Dorothy. Most of the players were so busy suspecting Dorothy, Alavia, and Heather that they rarely suspected Bill of sabotage, but he actually sabotaged games all season long. Let's take a look at how he did it.
Sabotage every game. Since the beginning, Bill was looking for opportunities to undermine the team's efforts. As the producers expected, the other players selected him to be a leader of the very first game they played.
We're told to pick the teams, and Darwin said, let's pick our best athletes for this first game.
Bill went out of his way to pick players unsuitable for the games.
I rarely leave my house except for work.
I found out that Rob described himself as a total non-athlete, never rides a bicycle, never does anything.
Maybe Rob for the bike also.
Yeah.
Darwin says, what do you think about Rob? I said, great, let's pick Rob. Let's bet $40,000 on this and go for it.
Go, Rob!
You got plenty of time. Take it easy.
The mole's plan to prey on the weaknesses of his teammates seemed to be working. His next target, Al.
I knew how Al had an upset stomach. I knew his pulse rate was going to be higher than normal. So I put him on the rope. It's real simple.
I'm fine.
Although Bill's logic was sound, Rob and Al ended up doing better than he expected and helped win the game. Players won, mole zero. It's a round of sabotage. Bill refused to wear a diaper.
Not a chance in hell.
Not a chance in hell.
They come out with a diaper, I look at it and say, boy, I gotta tell you, ladies, I'm not sure that I can wear that. And then Alavia took over. She went back and tried it on and came out. And she said, I really don't want to wear it either. But I will if you all really want to. Dorothy said the same thing.
It's an unappealing prospect.
It's only a 6-week show. We're going to have a lot of opportunities to spend a lot of money without doing stuff like this.
Okay, so let's pass.
That cost the group $20,000.
When Bribs and Allie took a detour on the way to the train station, the other players unwittingly sent the mole out to look for them.
We found them very quickly, only to find out they'd been sitting in a bar, and they said, yeah, if we had more money, we'd have drank beer. And I said, well, I've got more money. Let's go back and drink beer. So we go back to the bar.
Bill managed to stall them for another 30 minutes. Knowing that the group back at the train station was furious, he decided to add more fuel to the fire.
I made the suggestion, geez, you know, they were afraid y'all got an exemption. Why don't you tell them you got one? And Allie decided to do that.
What the hell were you guys doing?
Yeah, where were you? Bribs and I were offered an exemption, and I'm going to tell you we took it. And we're not getting on the train.
Thinking the game was already lost, Darwin ripped off his bunny ears and cost the group an additional $2,000 fine.
And then we get on the train, and here is the greatest spectacle I've ever seen.
What made you think it was okay to get here 2 hours and 20 minutes late? I mean, well, how is that okay?
Here is a guy in a girdle and a corset, a guy in a bunny costume, and a guy in a pink slip, nose to nose, yelling at each other, arguing about whether or not they should have stopped and drank beer or not. It was so funny, I just had to sit back and laugh. It was just delightful.
The players ended up losing a total of $22,000. Bill managed to sabotage the group without looking suspicious to even those players who had taken part in his scheme.
Swimmers, you guys are basically the ticking clock. You will be in the pool, treading water.
When I swam the mile in a flight suit, I swam on my back the entire mile. It took me an hour and 40 minutes.
So you'll be fine.
In the Think or Sink game, Bill dropped out after only 8 minutes of treading water.
I was using my arms so vigorously under there on purpose that I knew I was going to fatigue him.
Bill, you all right?
Think, woman, think!
Everyone found it suspicious that an ex-Navy admiral was unable to tread water for any longer, but they chalked it up to Bill pretending to be the mole.
Yeah, I was a little suspicious when Bill dropped out. I don't think he's a mole, but I think he was trying to raise suspicion about himself.
You hear that, pose on the side of the pool there isn't helping out very.
In episode 6, Bill once again resorted to subtle sabotage that he hoped would cast suspicion on others.
We'd been told clearly that we were not to eat anything after the pizza. That was all of our food for the day. And Darwin was looking at the ice cream case. Well, I always carried money. You never know when somebody's going to need beer or ice cream.
How'd you get ice cream?
Bought it. Down there.
Bill lent me money I got.
Bill's good about lending money.
So even though I was unsuccessful in any attempts to cost any major money that day, we lost $10,000.
The mole's next big sabotage would be in the gnome home game.
I had been told to manage to drop the gnome and break it.
He broke the gnome, costing $30,000 for the team, and earned a useless exemption for himself. In episode 9, Bill was instructed to slow down the assembly line game. He got the other players to take apart the car, even though he knew it would never fit through the greenhouse door.
So we're not going to be able to go straight in there like this.
The car's going to have to come off for sure. This is going to have to come off.
Bill got them to focus their attention on taking apart the car so they wouldn't notice the lock on the greenhouse door. And he kept their attention away from the odometer, which held the combination to the lock.
In spite of all of that, due to Dorothy's intuition, they found the combination, and in fact, we did win that money.
I got it, guys.
What was it?
3, 4, 5, 6.
3, 4, 5, 6?
Yeah.
That night, Bill successfully sabotaged the all-night ball game.
I was told to be the third person to volunteer to go to bed. Al went out first, Heather went out second. And as soon as Heather went out, I started laying down and doing a lot of back exercises. I almost missed the ball several times because I was sleepy. And so by the time Anderson came in again, the other three were ready for me to leave because they were afraid I was going to cost them money.
I need to know who's the most tired.
Bill.
Bill, you're the most tired?
Yeah, I guess.
Anderson immediately, at that point, offered me an exemption if I would stop the game.
Let's go home.
He ended the game in the third round and lost $30,000 for the team. In episode 10, Bill was instructed to try to sabotage the buy and sell game.
Oh, yeah. Game sucked. We did not win any money on that game. I don't think it was because I was a mole, just because we were all such inept sellers. We couldn't have sold ice in the desert that day.
Bill's final and most blatant sabotage came in episode 12 during the Three Questions game. He intentionally answered questions wrong in each round, losing the game and $30,000.
Question number three, Bill was asked, who is more likely to be alone in 10 years?
We answered Dorothy because she's about to get married.
I answered Heather, and I answered Heather because statistically, more than 50% of all marriages end in divorce within 5 years.
So I'm sorry, didn't earn any money in this game.
It was tough, but it was just a heck of a challenge to try to do that and carry it off successfully. I thoroughly enjoyed it. Being the mole was one of the hardest things I've ever done, but one of the funnest things I've ever done.
Congratulations, Bill. You did a great job. What was the hardest part about it?
I've been in the Navy all my life, and I've been used to being part of an organization that works together as a team to get to accomplish a problem. And in this case, the team was working against me, and I was working purely by myself. That was the hardest part. And the second part is just the... We were all duplicitous, but I had to be doubly so. I had to be normal and act normal and try to have normal reactions and yet do all those little things that just would keep them away from me.
Did you ever slip up and reveal your identity?
When Heather, you came up to me one time, you said, I wish that people, it was one of the things, how far away from Anderson did somebody sit? Mm-hmm. And you said, God, I wish we didn't have to write all these towns. I said, I always sit in the same spot, I started to say, because, you know, in my mind, I'm the mole, I always, and then I said, I always sit in the same spot so that at least I'll know where I am. And, didn't make any sense whatsoever, and you accepted that, and that was fine.
What about when we switched journals? I mean, that was a game that made everyone nervous. Did that concern you?
I got the mole's journal, and I didn't do anything with it.
Until the day before, that journal had been blank.
You didn't know, in fact,
as soon as they told me that, I started filling out this long, long letter to my wife.
It was a very nice letter.
It was a very nice letter to my wife.
That indicated that you were the mole.
Everything in there that I said was the truth, but it was all made up the night before. I've got to tell y'all, I mean, I was so totally paranoid that night up in the cabin. You all were talking. You had so much in common, I felt like I just didn't have anything.
Well, Bill, as I said before, you did just a really amazing, amazing job. So there were also hidden clues in every episode, as we told you. I know you didn't get them during the game, but some of you may have picked up on them while you're watching at home. Let's take a look at the hidden clues.
In every episode, there was at least one clue to the identity of the mole. Some were subtle and others more obvious, but they all pointed to the mole. The first clue was in episode one. You may have noticed that all the nighttime skies were devoid of any stars, except for one shot. In this shot, the nighttime sky was digitally enhanced to show the constellation Pisces. If you had checked out the player profiles at ABC.com, you'd know that Bill is a Pisces. In episode 2, just before the execution, there are two shots of zodiac signs. The second sign leading to the execution is again Bill's sign, Pisces. And what better place for a clue than in the mole's own journal?
Round 1, executed player, Bob. It was almost too easy. If only he'd spent less time schmoozing the ladies and more time paying attention.
The operative phrase in this clue was schmoozing the ladies. Had the players thought about this phrase, they would have realized they should stop wasting time on the women and spend more time focusing on the men. Episode 4's clue was given directly to the players. They received a telegram when they arrived in Italy, signed La Talpa, or The Mole.
I figure this is a great bit of intelligence. There's something in this telegram that may be helpful.
Patrick was correct, because in the bottom right-hand corner was a series of digits that didn't appear to be a telephone number. When using a telephone keypad as a decoder, the numbers spell out the name Bill. If you decode the rest of the line, the sentence reads, "The mole is Bill." In the fifth episode, the clue came during the Think or Sink game.
Around here, people say William Shakespeare is a scoundrel because he stole the story of Romeo and Juliet from the true author, Luigi de Porto.
When I referred to a scoundrel, I was not only referring to William Shakespeare, but also to Bill the Mole, whose first name is also William.
I got a beautiful bottle of red La Mole wine.
In episode 6, as the players rode their bicycles, I handed them a bottle of La Mole wine while eating an apple. First to Al, then Olavia.
Here's your bottle of wine.
What do apples have to do with La Mole? The apple is the official symbol of Washington State, home of the mole. In episode 7, each player was asked to make a list.
Each of you has a dollar bill placed in front of you. You're going to be using that dollar bill to rank your fellow players.
What's the value of a U.S. dollar bill in Italy? It buys you the mole's name, Bill.
I actually had a dream. I was in the room where we take a quiz. I look up at the ceiling and I realize that there's a picture on the ceiling, and it's a picture of who the mole is. And it happened to be Bill in the picture. And I remember looking up and thinking, Bill's the mole. And if I had just looked up, I would have known from the very beginning. Oh, it's so easy. It's just right there. It's right in front of me.
There were no pictures featured in any of the quizzes, except in episode 8, where we showed a ship behind the players as they took the quiz, hinting at the mole's former career as a Navy admiral. Heather was the only player to pick up on this, if only subconsciously. This clue appeared just one day before her mysterious dream. Watch for the hidden clue to the identity of the mole. If indeed you were watching for that hidden clue, you would have just seen it, because in episode 9, the clue is in the opening title, pointing for the second time to the mole's military career.
Avviso Bella!
The mole clue in episode 10 was a reminder of an earlier clue the players had already received. Again, this clue alluded to William Shakespeare.
Like, I didn't even see the guy had the book in his hand. It was Romeo and Juliet.
Though they picked up on it, they misinterpreted the clue.
The Romeo and Juliet book obviously was a clue.
The first clue of episode 11 pointed again to the mole's former career in the Navy. Just before the scene in the funhouse, there were three successive shots of ships. The second clue came in the final meal before the execution.
For one of you, this is your last supper. Compliment of Mickey D's.
Mickey D's is just a play on words, because Bill's last name is McDaniel. The final clue to the identity of the mole was clearly spelled out. Once again, in the title sequence, hidden among the random falling letters and numbers, was the sentence, Bill is the mole.
And so Dorothy, the winner, walks home with a prize, $636,000. Bill, the mole, goes home with the satisfaction of a job well done. And the others? Well, there are not many more stressful situations than the ones these players had to endure. Despite the fact they all wanted to be friends, betrayal was the name of the game, and all but one fell victim to the mole. Good night, everyone.